Schools across the country today opened their gates to welcome learners for first term. At several bus and taxi parks in Kampala, pupils and students poured into the city to commute further to school. The taxi managers in Kampala advised parents to always escort their children to the taxi and bus parks. They warned that there is an increasing number of thieves and crooks who disguise themselves as guides to take advantage of the students returning to school, only to steal their cash and valuables. We follow up on the drivers to see that they drive well to avoid causing accidents. Drivers should stick to their routes.
Moroka ezigenda yo zezo ezigenda yo bulijjo so sitwagala moroka mpya genda yo lokuba waliwo abantu abagenda yo.
A visit to several schools in Kampala, especially the government aided ones, portrayed in low turnout.
You said this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
At Nakasero Primary School, out of the over 2,000 pupils, only about 600 turned up on day one.
The turn up is not so good and not so bad. I can say it is 50-50. Because most of our learners, they're just on the way coming.
The head teacher of Nakasero Primary School, Gerald Mujasi, called for the timely release of the capitation grant.
You know, we have financial challenges, we have administrative challenges, we have attitude challenges, things like teachers, don't have enough teachers, those are there. But we are here to go. And as administrator, you cannot sit and begin lamenting. No. We have to use the little that which is there and we get going. So that's what we are right now doing. I cannot sit at the administrator and say, because I don't have enough teachers, children should not learn. No. The teachers who are there, we are moving on with them.
In Kagadi district, the heavy morning downpour interrupted the turn-up of students and pupils for term one. Students, especially in candidate classes who turned up on day one, thanked teachers.
I have reported today and the situation is well in school. The teachers are there, they are teaching. We have already studied, for example, we have already studied ICT in the morning. And the way how I see the situation is at a school, the students have all reported, we are over 6,000, I think now the preparation, the turnout.
Me too. Come to A level, I passed very well, I was disciplined, and I encourage other girls to be disciplined, hardworking, so that they can also come to A level.
In Yumbe, most schools at Lodonga Demonstration School, less than 100 learners out of over 1,000 reported for school.
And as being the head teacher, I'm also on duty myself. And when I was now opening the day, I received the number of children to begin the day, and also registration of term one is still also going on.
Coming to pick to register their children yet, and as the registration goes on, I'm seeing that the children are being registered, but we have a challenge of some report cards of last year not being picked by the parents, and this is piling work of last year and this year on us. But otherwise, the turnout of parents is very good. They are registering their children. Others are coming to pick the results of candidates of last year. I see really the way the term has begun. Is the structures of the school are well prepared. Unfortunately enough, the parents, the PTA committee, the SMCs had already made a plan that they had prepared the classrooms well swept, they had mopped the desks, children merely just come and enter into the classes.
Today, the first day, my enrollment was fair. I received the 312 learners from P1 to P7. Out of my 25 teachers, 24 teachers turned up, except one is sick, admitted in the hospital. I am happy. Today we had a series of activities. On the first day, my teachers entered into class to start correcting the handwriting of learners. And after that, we had our staff meeting of how we want the year to look like. I want to encourage my parents to send my learners to school because we have officially opened. This academic year has started. The journey is very short. Around November to December, they will be closing.
In Kasese, the magistrate's court has ordered Unique Valley Primary School to close and vacate their current location due to failure to pay ground rent worth over 100 million shillings for the last 6 years. News of its impending closure has left parents stranded. A team of security men led by the deputy RDC and court bailiffs visited the school located within Central Division of Kasese Municipality and ordered the school proprietors not to open the school doors for the learners. Representatives of Nyakatonzi Growers Cooperative Union, the owners of the land, say they have been patient with the school, but they failed to pay up.
That's why we are saying that you may pick a word, but this word you are picking
shall follow the law until we re-enter and repossess our property. So they need to vacate. They need to vacate our property. The property belongs to us. They have breached the agreement, the contract, and they have not been empathetic to the union.
They can convince Nyakatonzi to extend their tenancy. That's better for them. They can undertake a fresh tenancy arrangement.
Efforts to talk to the proprietors of the school were futile. Stories compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya, Solomon Okabo, Andrew Musinguzi, Adam Gule and Samuel Amanyire for the news.